Hi.
When I think of divine feminine, I just think of this beautiful, otherworldly power that is within all of us. And I often think about the divine feminine as something that we've almost lost touch with, you know, because a lot of masculine energy circles everything. And like Deepak said, everyone comes from a mother, and there's this almost like godliness, this divinity from that birth of a child and that ability to create something from nothing. And so there's a power in that, there's a strength in that, and that divine feminine strength is inside of all of us, and it's something that really centers around intuition and nurturing and kindness and gentleness and giving and all of these things that, you know, kind of when you think of a loved one to you that has a feminine energy, a divine feminine energy, I think you feel these kind of emotions from them. I love it, and I love this idea that we all have the ability to access that within us. Even if you're a man or however you identify, you can access your divine feminine, and within us all lives both the feminine and the masculine. And that's what we're talking about with this 21-day meditation. And it means so much to me because I think if we can balance that inside of ourselves more and get more used to this concept, I think there's a level of confidence, there's a level of love, there's a level of growth and power that we would be able to access. It means a lot to me too because I have two boys that I'm raising, and I want them to be able to access their divine feminine. I want them to be able to access this side of thoughtfulness and empathy and all those things that a lot of times I think the world tells boys, nah, just be hard, don't cry, don't show emotion, that's what a man does, and it's not real. So talking about it and exploring it and creating a 21-day meditation around it that we can all get into, I love it, it's my kind of thing. I love rituals so much. I mean, my soul care, Keys soul care line all has to do with rituals, because a lot of times I think things feel empty. You know, we don't really have a connection to these things that we can pour into ourselves or feed ourselves with that make us feel better, make us feel more confident, make us feel capable, you know? And so some of mine are, I do love mantras. I will create a mantra out of thin air. You know, like today I'll be like, please give me patience and thoughtfulness. And if that's what I happen to need in that day, I'll just make a mantra out of it and I'll speak it into existence, because I really think that you can create the energy around you with what you say. So I love mantras, that's a big one. I love journal writing, I'm a big journaler. I love how that feels to let it off your chest, to just write things down, get it out. That's a big one. Being active too, I love yoga and just doing different strength workouts and things like that. I find that that gives me a certain grounded feeling, and that's a ritual for me. So all these things are different ways that I'm able to pour into myself so that I can feel good and create that around me, you know? Really love meditation. It does do something for me that I never knew I needed. It creates an access point that I can hear myself better. I can hear, what do I feel? What do I think? What am I wanting? I think more than ever, meditation is really powerful because it's crazy. The world is out of its mind. Like, how are you supposed to feel within that? A lot of the times we're all battling insecurities, we're battling anxiety, we're battling depression. We have all these things that we're picking up because of what's around us. And it feels like meditation for me, it's just such a really powerful tool to center yourself and ground yourself. And so there's something really powerful of going inward and being able to strengthen that practice, that muscle. Your instinct is like your guide. If you can't hear it, how can you know where to go? I was so blessed to know Deepak in a personal way, because he actually married my husband and I. Like, he did the vows, he created the ceremony. It was really, really beautiful. He came and just really created such a beautiful memory for us and all of our friends and family. We are blessed with that memory, of that special day for Swiss and I, and with Deepak being the one to really officiate it and create the ceremony for it and marry us. If I'm not connected to him, I don't know who is.